it works. Okay, so this is the way how you create a binary search tree in the memory. So this is a data structure. Now, just by making it, you cannot check whether it has been successfully created. For that purpose, you have to traverse the binary search tree in one of the order. It can be in order, it can be pre-order, or it can be post. In one of the sequence, you have to traverse it, and those traversal algorithms are generally very, very simple. It can be written using recursive techniques. That is a function calling by itself. You can write recursive program, and all the traversal algorithms can be implemented. But how the recursive function is working, that is slightly matter of discussion. That also we will discuss. So now the next thing is traversal algorithm, that is the actual implementation of traversal algorithm, and then how the traversal algorithms are basically working. Because the traversal algorithm will be writing using recursive technique, that is a function calling by itself. Okay, we'll continue with now the traversal algorithm, that is the traversal algorithms of how to traverse a binary search tree. At the theoretical, we have already discussed the theoretical concepts, how binary search trees are to be traversed. There are three popular techniques of traversing a binary search tree. They are in order traversal, pre-order traversal, and then post-order traversal. Okay. All these algorithms can be implemented through recursion, which are very, very simple in implementation. That is, the coding part of in-order, pre-order and post-order are extremely simple, but how it is working inside is to be really analyzed. Otherwise, you will not understand how the system stack is actually working behind the background. So first we will write the recursive program for all these traversals, and then we will analyze one of the traversal algorithm using system stack, and the various intermediate stages of the system stack can be studied in order to understand how the output actually comes. Therefore, we will write the in-order algorithm. In in-order algorithm, what we normally do is we have to invoke the in-order function, wherein you pass the address of the root node as a pointer. That is the external pointer to the tree is to be passed as a parameter, right? And that address will be received here, and then it will be processed for traversing through the tree, right? So invoking the function will be like this. That is in order tree. So this is the way how you invoke the function from the main program, or where you have created the binary search tree, and tree is the external pointer to the tree. So we are calling now, how, let us write the recursive function for this. That is, the function is basically a void function, void in order node pointer t, void in order node pointer t. Okay, so here the value of tree will be assigned to t, and then we will be using t for traversing the tree. Okay, so the function goes like this, or the recursive function goes like this. It's a very simple thing. Has only a few steps. If t not equal to null, now you have to remember only one thing. What is in order? In order, what we do is you have to traverse, or you have to visit all the left subtree before visiting a node, then visit the node, and then visit all the nodes in its right subtree. This is the procedure. So here, that sequence is to be implemented. That is, first thing, before. That is, IFTI is not IFTI not. That is, it is coming with the address of a node. When you call the function for the first time, it is coming with the address of the root node inside the program. Now, can we process that? No, we cannot process that node. Before processing that node, we have to process or we have to visit all the nodes in its left subtree. Therefore, the first thing is that you have to go to the same function is to be applied to its left subtree. Therefore, here the first thing is you have to go to the left child using the same technique. So here you will be calling the function in order T left. That is, here you are calling the function with the left child of this. That is, the left child is to be visited first. Then again, if that is not null, again, that also cannot be visited. You have to go to the left side of this. So it will be taken care of by the recur in order T left. And then you can process it. By processing, in order to know whether you are really reaching there, you can make a print statement. That is, so here it will be print of %id t info. Okay, so you are basically printing the contents. You are basically printing the contents of the node whose address is T. And then you have to go to the right side. Therefore, the function will be like this. In order, E right. Okay. So, it is an extremely simple program. That is, this is the way how you traverse a binary search. It works wonderfully. But one thing is that you have to analyze how the function is working. That we will see. That is, one of the algorithms we will be discussing. That is, in order, pre order, or post order, we will be discussing one of it. And that can be, the other algorithm can be analyzed in the same way. That is, I will be analyzing one of the algorithm using system stack. Okay? We will be analyzing the position of the system stack at various levels. And then we will try to understand how the output is coming. So we will take an arbitrary binary tree or binary search tree or whatever it is. Okay. So this algorithm will work both for binary search tree and binary tree. Therefore, I will take an arbitrary binary tree and this algorithm will be implemented. Right? And we will analyze the various position of the stack. The intermediate position of the stack will be analyzed. Right? Now, so this is the in-order algorithm. And then in the same fashion, you can write the algorithm for both pre-order and post-order. Okay? The only thing is that the sequence is to be slightly shuffled. Okay? And then we can change the name also. That is, for give, the procedure has to be there. Therefore, now the function for pre-order. Pre-order, again, you call with the address of the root. Pre-order, tree. In pre-order, what you do is, you process the node, and then you process the left and right side. Right subtrees. Okay. Pre-order is node, then it's left, and then it's right. So that is the procedure. So, that sequence is to be implemented. So it will look like this. Void pre-order node pointer t. Void pre-order node pointer t. Okay. So here also the procedure is exactly same, but the sequence is slightly different. Okay. So if t is not equal to null, the procedure will be same thing, whereas, but the sequence is slightly different. If t not equal to null, that is print of person ID T info. Okay, so processing is to be done first, and then you have to go to the left and right subtree. Therefore, print up person ID T info, and then you have to call pre-order T left. Okay, and then pre-order T right. Pre-order T right. So this is the procedure. So here also the only thing is that the sequence is different. So here printing is first and then left and then right. So this is algorithm. Again, this is a recursive algorithm which ensures the visiting of all the nodes in a binary tree. Now, in the same way, exactly almost in the same way, you can write an algorithm for post order also by changing the sequence. So the function is to be called post order. Post order tree. This is the invoking of the function, and the function will be like this: void post order node pointer t. Void post order node pointer t, and it will be like this: if t not equal to null, again you have to memorize only the sequence. In post order, left will be done first, then right will be done, and then only the node will be done. Therefore, if t not equal to null, it will be post order. Post order T left, then post order T right, post order T left, post order T right, and then only we will be making the print of percentage D and T. So again, this is the procedure. Okay. So writing the actual C program for traversing pre-order, in-order and post-order are extremely simple. The whole traversal will be taken care of by the recursion, that is calling, the function calling by itself. Now let us analyze how this program is giving the output. That is, a beginner will not be able to understand how such a small program is taking care of the complete traversal. That is, even doing manually takes more amount of time. So how come such a small program is giving the output? So for that, we will take one of the algorithm, one of the program, and then with the system stack, we will try to trace the output, how the output is actually coming. So for that, I am taking an arbitrary binary tree. It's not a binary search tree, I am taking a binary tree itself. So here, we have a binary tree A, and the contents I have written inside every node A, B, C. Right. Here you have D, E, F, G, here you have H, here you have I, here you have J, here you have K, L and M. So this is an absolutely arbitrary tree. There is no reason for choosing this. Okay. An absolutely atypical binary tree. Fine. So this is A, B, C, E, G, D, J, F, okay, and then H, K. This is I. This is I, K, L, M, etc., etc., etc. So whatever I have written inside the note is the content of the note. Okay. Now, let us assume that the address of this node is A, capital A, capital B, whatever I am going to write outside, see, so this is D, and this is F, this is I, J, K, M, L, H, G, and E. I have written in capital letters outside the node. And let us assume that whatever I have written in capital outside every node is the address of that node. So, let me elaborate. That is, A is the address of this node. Therefore, this can be interpreted like this. That is, A info. Since A is the address of this node, A info is nothing but small a. That is the content of this node. A info is small a. And A left. That is, here you have the address. And this node, as I told you, it has got three parts. It is storing three informations. One is A info. What is an information part? One is the address of its left child. What is the address of its right child? Okay. So here, A left is nothing but what? It is the value which has stored here, which is nothing but the address of its left child, which is B. Therefore, A left is nothing but capital B, not small b. Small b is the content of that particular node. So small b, if you want to get A left, then info. That is it. So A left is capital B, and similarly A right is capital C. A left is capital B and A right is capital C. And A info is small a, which is the content of the particular node. So this concept should be clear. Once this concept is clear, the algorithm can be analyzed. Okay, now suppose the external point of this tree, let it be tree, this is a tree, so that means it is containing the address A. Basically, it is containing the address capital A. Capital A is nothing but the address of the root node. Now, using with all these premises, let me analyze this algorithm, the working of the in-order algorithm. And here we will be using a system stack to understand the sequence in which the various nodes will be visited in in-order fashion. Okay. So let me write the in-order algorithm once again. In-order. So here it is a void function. Void in-order. Node pointer t. Void in order node pointer t. Now, the algorithm goes like this, or the program goes like this. If t not equal to null, if t is not equal to null, in order, what we have to do? In order t left, in order t left, then the second step is print of t info, and then the third step is in order t right. Bracket is closed. Fine. This is the outer bracket and this is the inner bracket. This is the full recursive program. Now, we have to see how the algorithm is working with the help of a system stack. Okay, so I will be drawing a system stack and the various positions or the intermediate position of the stack will be explained by analyzing each step. When a recursive call is made, what happens to the pending jobs? That pending jobs are basically taken care of by the system stack. So let me draw a system stack here. This is a system stack in which any pending job, if any, will be stored. Pending jobs will be stored. That is, by pending job I mean, suppose if some condition is satisfied, the function, that is the recursive call is made. Then the step below that, so here you can see, if T not equal, if this condition is satisfied, you can see that here there is a call. So if this condition is satisfied, basically you are supposed to do these three jobs. If T is not equal to null, I should do this job and this job. There are three jobs to be done when T is not equal to null. But what happens when T is not equal to null? This itself is a function call. Therefore, from here the control goes back and then at that point of time, the program is not able to execute these two steps. That is, when T is not equal to null, there are three jobs to be done. Three jobs are to be performed. But what happens? Since this is a function call, this itself is a function call, the control goes back. Therefore, these two jobs will not be executed, which will go to the system stack and will be executed when this condition is not satisfied. That is, when T is equal to null. If T is not equal to null, you have to do. Again, when T is not equal to null, there are three jobs. Okay. So, at some point of time, what will happen will be T will become null. So, we will be storing all those pending jobs one by one on in a stack. We will be stacking it. The pending jobs will be stacked in the system stack, or it will be stored in the system stack one by one over the other. And when T becomes null, it will be taken out from the system stack one by one and it will be executed. It will be done. Fine. So this is what we are going to do here also. So let me make a system stack. So this is a system stack which is basically not transparent to the programmer. The programmer even do not know the existence of this, which will be taken care of by the compiler and the operating system. So this is your system stack, which is empty in the beginning. At the initial stage, it is empty. Now, here, so let us assume that you are making the call. Fine, that is in order, it is making the call in order tree. In order tree. This is the first invoking of the function. So the value of tree is equal to A. The value of tree is A. A is the address of the root node. It comes here. Now T gets a value. T is equal to A, which is the address of the root node. When the function is invoked for the first time, the value of T is equal to A. So now it comes over here. If T not equal to null, yes, T is not null. What is the value of T? T is A and T is not equal to null. Then what is to be done? In order T left, A left is to be called. So we will see. That is, from here, the control goes back. When T is equal to A left is nothing but B. We'll see it. So from here the call goes back. So what happens? These two jobs are pending. That is printing T info. What is printing T info? Print A info. Printing A info. What is A info? That is print capital A info. Capital A info is nothing but small A. The content of the node whose address is capital A is small a. So printing the value A is a pending job, so that goes to the stack, printing A. Why I am writing here? Because here two jobs are pending. Out of this, this is to be done first and this is to be done at a later stage. Therefore, this will go to the bottom and this will be on the top of that. Okay, that is why I left this particular column where this will be entered. This pending job will be entered. So, printing T info is nothing but printing A. Print small a, which is the content of the node whose address is capital A. Print A. Then similarly, in order T write is to be done. What is T write? It is A write. T is capital A. Capital A write is capital C, which is the address of this particular node. Therefore, I will write it here as in order C. Here this is the address I am writing. I am not writing A write. Rather, I am writing the value of it. That is A write is nothing but C, capital C. Okay. So now what happens? Here T left, that is A left. The call is A left. A left is nothing but B. Now so now the value of T is equal to B. Now the value of T is B. Again it is coming here. Just check up. If T not equal to null, T is not equal to null here also. Here the value of T is now B. Okay. The value of T is B. If T not equal to null, in order T left, that is B left is to be performed. B left, the call again goes.